Firebase Realtime Database is a NoSQL database that allows developers to store and synchronize data in real time. It has a simple, intuitive design and can be easily implemented in both simple and complex applications. As Pythoners ourselves, we may need to store and retrieve data for our Python scripts, and Firebase can be of great help for us. Firebase provides a free tier access to its real-time database, which we can integrate with a Python script using official Firebase SDK for Python. So in this video, I'm going to give you a step-by-step guide on how you can use Firebase SDK to retrieve and store data using Python. If you're into Python like me, you can join our community all about Python by subscribing on YouTube, following on Instagram, or joining our newsletter through our blog site allaboutpython.tech. So without any further ado, let's begin. Thanks to Google, setting up and getting started with Firebase is really easy. You can go to Firebase website, firebase.google.com, and create a new account using Google Sign Up. Once done, you can create a new project within Firebase. Each project here can represent an application or program which is using Firebase. Once the project is created, you can go to Build and click on Real-Time Database to get started with creating a real-time database for you. First, you need to set up the location of the database. You can select whichever location is closest to your location. Next, you need to select the mode to use in the database. Logged mode is used to grant access to only certain privileged accounts, while test mode will give you access to anyone who has the link to the database. For tutorial purpose, I would suggest using test mode, but for production environment, it's secure to use logged mode. Once the mode is selected, you can click on Enable to start creating the database. It will take a few seconds to complete, but once done, you will be able to see a screen similar to this one. The URL that you see here is our database URL. We will be using this URL within our Python script. With this, our database is ready to work. Before we dive into writing some code, we need to understand how a Firebase real-time database actually works. Like I told you before, this database is a NoSQL database, which means it does not involve the concept of tables, keys, or relationships. Instead, it uses a JSON-like structure to store data inside it called node. Developers can create these nodes as key-value pairs and store common data types like integer, float, string, list, and dictionary objects inside it. Each node has its own path, which represents its location within the database. For example, if you look at this JSON file here, you can see we have a bunch of key value pairs. Some keys store smaller JSON files inside it, which in turn have its own keys and values. Let's assume this data is stored in this exact format inside Firebase. The address of this whole data will be /, as this whole data is present at the root of the database. If I want the path to this node, name equals to Vishesh, then its address will be /name, as the name of the key of this node is name. Similarly, if I want the path to this node that stores the channel URL, its path will be /channel/URL, as this node is stored within this node with the key channel and the key name of this node is URL. We will use the same concept of path to navigate across the data stored in Firebase. If you have any issues understanding it, just continue with this tutorial as you will understand as we move on to the coding part. We will start by installing the Firebase SDK package for Python called firebase_admin. To install it, open command prompt and type pip install firebase_admin. And hit enter. Once the package is installed, we will go to the Firebase account and click on settings, present beside project overview, and then click on project settings. Next, we'll click on service account. Once the page is opened, we will click on generate new private key. This will download a JSON file on our system, which we will use to authenticate to Firebase. Now you can create a new folder to store the demo code and copy-paste the JSON file inside the folder. For ease of use, you can rename this file to credentials.json as I have done for this demo. Now we are ready to start with the coding part. For this demo, I am using Jupyter Notebook so that I could easily explain each and every line of code that we write. You can write the same code inside a Python file and it will work exactly the same. We will start by importing the required modules. Firstly, I will import the Firebase underscore admin module, and in the next line we will separately import a DB and credentials module from Firebase admin. Next, we will start by reading the JSON file that we had downloaded from the Firebase for authentication. We will create a variable named crud and store the object of class credentials.certificate. We will pass the path to the JSON file here. Since I've created this file on the same folder, I will just write the name of the file here. Next, we will call the Firebase underscore admin.initialize app function. This function is necessary to call before we perform any operation on the database. Within the function, we first pass the crud variable which stores the credentials from JSON file, and then we pass a dictionary object with key, database URL and a URL. This is our database URL, which you can get by opening the real-time database on web and copying this URL from here. After writing the URL, we will run this line and we will get an app object in return. Next, we will talk about references in Firebase Admin. References in Firebase Admin SDK are Python classes that are used to represent nodes in Firebase. Each reference object has a key, value and a set of functions used to perform operations on that specific node. If we want to perform any operation, we have to first get the node using the reference function and then we can perform any action on that node. We can create a reference object by calling db.reference function. Within the function, we can pass the path to the node in the database. For example, to get the root node, we will pass slash as a string to the function. We will also store the object returned in a variable named ref. Now we can use this reference object variable to perform operations on the database. The first operation we are going to talk about is the get operation. Using this, we can retrieve data from Firebase. Using this is very simple. You can use ref.key to get the name of the key of the reference, and you can use the get function to get the value of the reference. For example, if I use ref.key, you can see nothing gets displayed as ref here is the root node and root node is the only node that does not have any key name. But if we use ref.get, you can see that we get a dictionary object with lots of data. This is because I had already stored this value in the database, which you can see here. And now I am able to retrieve that value from Python. If I just want to get the value of the name key, I can mention that node by writing db.reference slash name and then calling the get function to get its value. On running it, we can see its value. The next operation we are going to talk about is the set operation. Using this, we can set any value inside an existing node using its key. We will use the set function for this. The function will override any existing value present inside the node with the new value passed on to this function. For example, if I want to set the value of videos key to just be 3 and not a list of numbers, I can write db.reference/videos.set3. If I run ref.get now, we can see that the videos key has value 3 now, and the old value of list of numbers got replaced with the new value. The next operation is the update operation. Using this, we can update any existing node with the new value. We will use the update function for this. Note that unlike the set operation, which replaces the node value with the new one, the update operation adds the new node to the existing node value. If the node is already present, it will just update its value. For example, If I want to change the value of language key without changing any other value, I can write db.reference/.update language colon python. If I run ref.get now, we can see that the language key has the value python and the old value of python with capital P got updated with the new value. If I want to add a new key using pair onto the root node, I can write db.reference/.update subscribed colon true. Now if I run ref.get, we can see that a new key value pair subscribed equals to true has been added to the root node. The next operation is the push operation. Using this, we can add a new child node to an existing node. We will use the push function for this. Note that when you use this operator, we also need to use the set operator to set the new value of the new node added to the parent node. This operation can also be used on a list to append a new element. For example, if I want to add a new title to the titles node, I can write db.reference/titles.push.set python playwright tutorial. If I run ref.get now, we can see that the titles key has the value python playwright tutorial added onto the list. If your Firebase real-time database is being used by multiple clients at the same time, it could be difficult to update values for all the clients. In order to resolve this, the concept of transactions exists. A transaction is used when you want to change small specific values by small increment at a time. For example, I've created a function here which takes in the current value of title count in root node and increments it by 1 and returns it. Then I create the root node reference and call the transaction function and pass the newly created function inside it. Now if I run it, the code will update the title count every time this line is executed. At last, we have the delete operation. As the name suggests, this operation is used to remove a key value pair. We use the delete method to perform this operation. We call the function on the reference object we want to delete. For example, if I want to remove the language key value pair from root, I will write db.reference/language.delete. And if I run the ref.get method, we can see that the language key value pair is removed. That's all for this video. Hope you liked it. If you did, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. With this, it's time for me to go. This is Vishesh Dwivedi signing off.